Hello friends, and welcome to Virtual Tech Box YouTube channel. Our today's topic is VMware HA. I will first explain you in short what is VMware HA and what are the requirements of the VMware HA, and then I will show you what happens if one ESXi host goes down in the VMware HA cluster. Let's start. VMware HA, that is high availability, which works on the host level and is configured on the cluster. A cluster configured with HA will migrate and restart all the VMs running under any of the host in case of any host level failure automatically to another host under the same cluster. VMware HA continuously monitors all ESXi servers host in a cluster and detects failure. VMware HA agent placed on each host maintains a heartbeat with the other host in the cluster using the service console network. Each server sends heartbeat to the other servers in the cluster at 5-second intervals. If any server lose heartbeat over 3 consecutive heartbeat intervals, VMware HA initiates the failure action of restarting all affected virtual machines on another host. You can set the virtual machine restart priority in case of any host failure depending upon the critical nature of the VM. All ESXi hosts must be on same version and same patch level. All ESXi hosts must share the common storage, that is shared storage. All ESXi hosts must have access to the VMs, data stores and networks. VMware HA must be enabled on the cluster. This is my vSphere 7 cluster created on the VMware workstation. You can click on I button and go to the video which explains in detail how to create the vSphere 7 home lab or vSphere 7 cluster on the VMware workstation. I will open the browser. I will type here the vCenter IP address, launch client, username administrator at the rate vsphere.local. I will give the password, login, so you can see here this is the my vCenter. Inside my vCenter I have created this data center. Inside the data center I have created one cluster, and in this vSphere 7 cluster I have added two hosts, 192.168.0.131 and 192.168.0.132, and this host 131 having one virtual machine on it and 132 is not having any virtual machine on it. So we will first enable the VMware HA on the cluster, and I will shut down this first host 131, so which will trigger the failover action, and this virtual machine should restart on the another host which is 132, and downtime should be equal to restart time of this Ubuntu virtual machine. To enable the VMware HA on the cluster, I will first select the cluster on the left side. I will go to configure, and inside configure I will go to vSphere availability, and I will go to edit, and I will enable here vSphere HA, which will enable host monitoring. And this default setting I will keep as it is. I will not change in it. Okay. So after enabling the HA on the cluster, you can see vSphere HA agent is being installed on the both host. You can see here vSphere HA agent is being installed on both the host. Because this HA is configured on the host level. You can see here the election process is showing, means master slave selection would happen. Okay, now all the configuration is showing configured for the HA. So now HA is configured on my vSphere 7 cluster. Here you can see if I select the cluster on the left side, it is showing vSphere HA is turned on, and in the case of host failure, restart VMs using VM restart priority ordering. So we are having one single virtual machine, so we have not enabled any restart priority list. So next task is to restart the, I will shut down the first host, which is 131, which should restart the virtual machine on it to the another host. So I will start the ping to my virtual machine, ping 192.168.0.134, which is the IP address of my Ubuntu virtual machine. Okay, now I will go to workstation and I will go to first host, which is 192.168.0.131. I will press F12, username root. I will give the password for the root, enter, and F2 to shut down the host. So now I will go to my cluster. You can see here now virtual machine is giving RTO, which means the failure action has started. Now it should restart on the another host. You can see here it is now showing my first host as shut down. Now you can see this virtual machine has again started pinging, means it has restarted on the second host, which is 192.168.0.132. If I go to 132 host, you can see here it is showing the virtual machine here, which means now this Ubuntu virtual machine is on second host, on 132. Due to failure action of the HA, it has been restarted on the second host. So here I have shown you how to configure the VMware HA and how to initiate the failure action and what happens if one host goes down in the VMware HA cluster. So we have seen what happens, that virtual machine on that host would be restarted on the other host in the cluster which is protected by the VMware HA. That's it for today, friends. Like the video, share this video with your friends and spread the knowledge. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.